We'll see how to configure IKEv2 IPsec site-to-site VPN on PfSense firewall. On my screen is the simple network topology, PfSense firewall with two interfaces, WAN2 and LAN. WAN2 with an IP 14.140.40.109, LAN with an IP 10.10.10.109/24, connecting to the internal subnet 10.10.10.0/24 behind the PfSense firewall, and the test machine from that subnet would be 10.10.10.12. On the other end, we have the Fortigate firewall WAN2 port 2 with an IP 14.140.40.108, LAN interface with an IP 20.20.20.108, connecting the internal subnet 20.20.20.0/24, which is behind the Fortigate firewall. And for testing purpose, we will be using the source as the LAN interface on Fortigate firewall 20.20.20.108. Let's try to configure the PfSense firewall. So this is the PfSense firewall running 2.7.2 release, and you can see the configuration on my WAN interfaces and the LAN interface. WAN2 with an IP 14.140.40.109, LAN 10.10.10.109. The remote gateway is already configured, which is Fortigate firewall. If you are interested in the configuration, you can refer the video that I have pinned on screen. Let's try to configure the IPsec IKEv2 site-to-site tunnel on the PfSense firewall. Click on VPN, click on IPsec, click on add P1. I'll name it as FG PfSense. Exchange version will be IKEv2. Internet protocol is going to be IPv4. Interface is going to be WAN2. Remote gateway is going to be 14.140.40.108. Authentication method is mutual pre-shared key. Identifier is my IP, peer IP. Pre-shared key is password. That has to match on both the gateways. Encryption algorithm inside the phase one proposal, AES-256. Hashing, SHA-256. Group 2, lifetime is 86400, enable DPD, click save. Now we have the phase 1 configured. Let's try to add phase 2, we'll name it as P2, mode is IPv4 tunnel, local network is going to be 10.10.10.0/24. Remote network is going to be 20.20.20.0/24. So this is the proxy ID, and based on the entries, the PfSense firewall will have a route added that will be referred for the IPsec traffic. Coming down to our phase 2 proposal, it is going to be AES-256, SHA-256, PFS is enabled, 14. Lifetime is 43200. Let's try to save this. Apply the changes. Now click on firewall. Come to the rules. On the WAN2, we'll have to allow the IPsec traffic. Click on add. Interface is going to be WAN2. Address family IPv4. Protocol is UDP. We'll have to specify the address. This is the peer IP on the Fortigate firewall. Destination is WAN2 subnet or WAN2 address. Let's try to log packets that are handled by this rule. Click save. Now we have the rule to allow the traffic on WAN2, which is the IPsec related rule that we have created on WAN2. Click on LAN. On LAN, you will have to create a rule to allow the traffic from the local subnet 10.10.10.0/24 towards the remote subnet 20.20.20.0/24. So we'll create that. Any source is going to be 10.10.10.0/24. Remote is going to be 20.20.20.0/24. Log packets that are handled by this rule. Click save. This is for the original traffic, which is coming from behind the PfSense firewall and which is hitting the LAN interface. And on the IPsec tunnel, we'll have to allow the traffic, which will be decrypted on the IPsec tunnel on the PfSense firewall. That will be coming from the Fortigate firewall. So inside the IPsec, you'll have to click add, action pass, interface IPsec, protocol any, source is the actual network, which is going to be 20.20.20.0/24, and destination is going to be 10.10.10.0/24. So on the IPsec tunnel, you will have to specify the original source and the original destination to allow the traffic. So make sure you note this particular configuration. So on the IPsec, this is going to be for the incoming traffic. We have allowed the traffic from the source 20.20.20.0 towards the destination 10.10.10.0/24. And on the LAN interface, the traffic is coming from the subnet, which is behind the PfSense firewall, going towards the Fortigate firewall. And on WAN2, we have allowed the IPsec traffic. Now let's try to check the status. On the PfSense firewall, you do not need to add the static route because the proxy ID that we have specified here in phase 2, local 10.10.10.0/24, remote 20.20.20.0/24, will be used for the routing purpose on the PfSense firewall to route the traffic onto the IPsec tunnel. Let's try to check the status of the IPsec. As you can see, it is already up because we have the TPD enabled and the phase 2 is also active. Let's try to check the connectivity. We are using Fortigate firewall LAN interface as the source, and this is the client machine behind the PfSense firewall. This is the CLI access of the PfSense firewall. As I was telling, this is the tunnel information. You can see it is in established state, and you can check the routing option, the proxy ID that we have mentioned, based on which the PfSense firewall will route the traffic onto the IPsec tunnel. Let me try to initiate some traffic from the LAN interface on the Fortigate firewall towards 10.10.10.12, which is the system behind the PfSense firewall. And you can clearly see that I'm able to ping. And on the PfSense firewall, you can take a TCP dump to confirm that. Let's try to initiate the traffic again. And you can clearly see that the traffic is going through the tunnel interface on the PfSense firewall and the reply coming back. Now let's try to initiate some traffic from client machine in the subnet 10.10.10.0/24, which is having an IP 10.10.10.12. And you can see we are able to initiate the traffic from the client machine in the subnet 10.10.10.0/24 towards the remote IP 20.20.20.108. And we can check the status on the IPsec tunnel as well. The traffic initiated from the client machine behind the PfSense file. That's all in this video. Please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Hit the like button. See you in the next video.